that loves to praise God in this room. Lift your voice. Come on, let's celebrate him tonight because he's worthy of praise, glory, and honor. Turn around and tell somebody he's even more than, more than. Touch two, three people, say more than, more than, more than, more than. I wish somebody would make some noise in here like they came to celebrate Jesus. Cause it's all about him. It's not about us. His name was full of glory. My God. I think about all the good things that you did for me, Lord. It makes me want to sing a song to you. For greater things yet to come. I say this. What can I say? My God. About your mercy, what can I say? About your grace, all that I know is that you've been faithful. All that I know is I love to call your name. What can I say? About your mercy, what can I say, my God? About your grace, all that I know is that you've been faithful. One thing for sure is I love to call your name. Now if I say you're good, you've been
better than that.
If I say you're great, you've been
greater than that.
If I say you're sweet, you've been
sweeter than that.
You've been
more and more.
Talking about you, my Lord. If I say you're rich, you've been
richer than that.
If I say you're strong, you've been
stronger than that.
If I say you're holy, you've
more than that.
You've been
more and more in my life.
Shoot, do, 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 do. He'll make you wanna sing. Makes me wanna sing. I wish some folk would dance a little bit here and have a good time. That's what we're here for tonight, his presence. What can I say about your mercy? What can I say about your grace? All that I know is that you've been faithful. One thing for sure is I love to call your name. Now if I say you're good, you've been
better than that.
If I say you're great, you've been
greater than that.
If I say you're sweet, you've been
sweeter than that.
You've been
more and more in my life.
Will you help us say, help us say? If I say you're rich, you've been
richer than that.
And if I say you're strong, you've been
stronger than that.
If I say you're holy, you're
more than that.
You've been
more and more in my life.
Can you say it again? It's been
more and more in my life.
You know you've been
more and more in my life.
Come on, can you help us say
more?
Come on, come on. Did anybody come to celebrate Jesus and have a good time tonight? Shoot, doop, doop, shoot. He'll make you want to sing. Now come on, y'all, lift your voice. Help us say it tonight. Help us say, say, if I say you're good, you've been
better than that.
Come on, say it now. If I say you're great, you've been
greater than that.
If I say you're sweet, you've been
sweeter than that.
You've been
more and more.
Come on, talk to your father tonight. Talk to your father tonight. Come on, tell him tonight. If I say you're rich, you've been.
Good morning, and welcome to the Forestville New Redeemer live stream worship service. We are beyond excited and blessed to have you join with us today. In the midst of social distancing, we are blessed to be able to continue to share in worship and a word through our various social media platforms. If you are joining with us on Facebook, we'd ask that you like our Facebook page and share this video with your followers, family, and friends. If this is your first time joining us, type first time in the comment section. We love to connect with you. If you want to know more about our ministry or simply desire prayer, visit our website at www.forestvillenewredeemer.org and click on the tab Prayer Requests, or you can call our church line at 301-736-4488. Someone will respond and connect with you as soon as possible. We want to invite you to our weekly prayer call every Tuesday evening at 8 p.m., as well as our weekly Bible study every Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. You can join via our website and Facebook live stream, or you can dial in through the phone. The number, ID, and code can be found below and on our website. We also now hold Saturday Sunday School on Saturday mornings from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. We've continued our discussion from the book, God is Closer Than You Think by John Ortberg, and we invite you all to join our discussion as we continue to grow together in the Word of God. Please email us at FNRBCinfo@ForestvilleNewRedeemer.org to gain information to log in. We also want to send a special blessing and thank you to all of our first responders in the hospitals, grocery stores, and all over. We thank you for your service, and we will continue to keep you in our prayers.
Our scripture today is coming from Acts, the second chapter, verses 1 through 4. I'll be reading from the NIV version. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. This is God's word. Amen. Good morning, Forestville New Redeemer. Everyone who's watching us our service today via the live stream, we'll just go ahead and be a blessing today to the Lord. And today we're going to talk about our tithes and our offering. And before I do so, I just want to encourage you with this scripture, what God promises is to us. Amen. And today's scripture is going to be coming from Proverbs chapter 3, verses 9 through 10. So let's read that scripture. Let's go there. Amen. And it says this: honor the Lord with your possessions and with the first fruit of all your increase, so your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine. And see here, that it says giving to the Lord is an act of honor. It is a way of thanking God for all that, you know, he has provided us in our lives. You know, God, he supplies all our needs by his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. And, you know, and I think one of the least things that we can do is honor him with the first fruit of our increase. Amen. But you know what? The scripture don't just stop there, though. It goes on and it says that the Lord says that your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine. Hallelujah. What an amazing thing. If you honor God with your finances and stay faithful to him, hallelujah, he will bless you financially until your vats overflow. So let's honor God this morning and give. And you know, just like we always do, we're going to do our confession. So, you know, if you heard that scripture today, just believe this. Lord, I come to you today to honor you in your house. I present my tithe and my offering to you as a gift and a sacrifice of honor. And I believe that you will bless me and that my barns will be filled with plenty and my vats will overflow. I stand on your word and act on my faith. Amen. Hallelujah. You believe that today. And you stand on God's word. I'm sure, surely he will keep his promises. Let us pray. Father, we thank you today for your Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord God, for the givers today. We thank you for the tithe and the offering. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that this is a brand new day that you have given us another opportunity, Lord God, to walk with you. the Lord God, have your way in this service this morning. Have your way, O Lord God, with this tithe and this offering. And may it be used, O Lord God, to continue to edify and to build your kingdom. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Celebrate this blessed occasion. We want to encourage you to sow into our ministry. There are three ways you can give. Text Forestville to 77977. Or you can visit our website at www.forestvillenewredeemer.org and click on the Giving tab. Lastly, you can also mail in your giving to our church at 7808 Marlboro Pike, Forestville, Maryland, 20747. We are grateful for your giving and pray God's blessings upon you.
Not a second or another minute, not an hour or another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, Lord, I need you to make a way, as you have done so many times before. Through a window, an open door, I stretch my hands to thee. God, come rescue me. I need you right away. I need you now. I need you now. I need you now. I need you now. Not another second or another minute, not an hour or another day, but Lord, I need you right away. If we never needed you before to show up and restore all the faith that I let slip while I was yet searching the world for more, the truest friend I have need. You're the best friend I know in me. God, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me. We need you right away. Hey, hey. Agony of being alone, fear of doing things on our own, the tests and trials that come to make us strong, the feelings of guilt, hurt, pain, and discreet. Ha! Don't make those worries come over me, but in you, Lord, victory. Yeah, I need you now, Lord, I need you now. I need you right now, right now. Now I need you now. Not another second or another minute. Lord, I can't wait another day. Ooh, please make a way, Lord. We need you more than we've ever needed you before, Jesus. Come, Lord, come, Lord. Come, Lord, come, Lord. We need you, Lord.
Thank you, Dr. Brower. Thank you so very much. What a song, what a song, what a song. I need you now. I don't know about you, but I know I need God every day. I need him every day of my life. And I know many of you need God in your lives every day. Today is our Communion Sunday, and I'm asking all of our people to prepare themselves later in this broadcast for our communion. Again, we thank all of you for joining our broadcast this morning. And if this is your first time, as Minister Coatley has already indicated, if this is your first time, please type in first time. And we also ask that you like our Facebook. Like our Facebook page. Tell your friends and tell your neighbors. Tell your other contacts to tap in to this service this morning. I just want you to let us know that you are communicating with us. Amen. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we come this day, O God, as humble as we know how to say thank you. I'm asking you, O God, that as I begin to share the message this morning, O God, put me in the background because you are the one that is at the foreground. O God, continue to give the wisdom, the knowledge that will come with clarity and understanding. Bless right now in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You have already heard the text read this morning from Acts 2. And I just want to lift up Acts 2 and 4. And it says, And they hired all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And I just want to share a thought with you this morning, the flow of God's power. The flow of God's power. You know, we look at this text, there was a day of Pentecost. And I know some may ask, well, what was Pentecost? Well, in the New Testament, the day that the Holy Spirit descended upon the disciples. Matter of fact, Pentecost commemorated the descent of the Holy Spirit on the apostles as well as the disciples following the crucifixion, the resurrection, and the ascension of Jesus the Christ. After being with Jesus for his years of ministry, being with him for his 40 days after his resurrection, and then witnessing his return to heaven, believers needed this event to help them be what Jesus wanted them to be. You know, I was looking at some research coming from the Bonner Research Group, and it was very interesting that how many of us think or have thought about not only the resurrection, but what Christ means to us. And there were seven areas that stuck out with me. And one of them was that faith is very important in our lives. This research was given back in the time of 2004 when this was done. That faith was very important to our life. The second is that many of us have a personal relationship and responsibility to share the word of Christ, not among ourselves, but among non-believers. And then third is that we stood fast on the word, stating that Satan does exist. Monitoring, number four, monitoring the internal salvation is possible only if through grace, not being good or doing good deeds. Let me repeat that again. Maintaining that eternal salvation, it is possible only through grace, not just doing good deeds. Number five, asserting that Jesus lived a sinless life here on earth. Six, saying that the Bible is totally accurate in all teachings. And then number seven, this is what the research revealed about us, is that we believe that describing God as the all-knowing, the all-powerful, perfect deity who creates the universe and still rules today. Now, that was the research then, but it seems like here in recent time, we don't talk much about the existence of Satan and what Satan is doing. It is suggested that even sometimes we are getting or moving, it appears, slowly into our good works versus grace, that our good works are going to get us into heaven. And saying that the Bible is totally accurate, we're beginning to sort of, there's some who are even in our communities are saying that the Bible has been misinterpreted. These are some dangers that we are faced with. But we got to be able to deal with these issues if we are dealing with the flow of God's power. Because we got to be exacting when it comes to understanding that the Bible is totally accurate in all teachings. In order to deal with the flow of God's power, we got to also understand that Satan does exist. Flowing in God's power, we got to be able to describe God as all-knowing, not some knowing, but all-knowing, all-powerful. And he is the perfect deity who creates the universe and is still the same God yesterday, today, and will be the same God forevermore. In this first verse of the second chapter, the Holy Spirit came 50 days after his resurrection and 10 days after the ascension. Tongue symbolizes the speech and communication of the gospel. Cloven tongues means the fire separated and rest that rests in each of us. Fire symbolizes God's purity, presence, is purifying presence, which burns away the undesirable elements of our lives and set our hearts aflame. In order to get this fire, there are some things that are necessary as we think about the flow of God's power. Number one, I want to share with you that we need to become empty that we might be filled. these earlier disciples had to get rid of some things in their lives that kept them from what God had for them in their lives. The flow of God's power. We got to become empty. When I look over at Ephesians 4, the 4th chapter, 21:31. But Paul here says that if you heard him, who is him? If you heard Christ and been taught by him, you would put off the former conversations of man. Let me say that again. If you heard him and have been taught by him, you will put off the former conversations of man. In other words, Paul is telling the Ephesians to leave behind the old life of sin. Empty yourselves from old baggage. What does this have to do with tongues? Well, we're gonna find out in a little while. Don't let any unwholesome talk come out of our mouths, but only what is helpful for building up others and building the kingdom of God. In other words, we got to be careful what comes out of our mouths. The 23rd verse here deals with that we be renewed. Let me say it again. That we be renewed in the spirit of our minds and put on a new man, which after God is created in righteousness and in true holiness. I'm just talking a little bit here right now about the flow to God's power. We got to come with a new renewal of our spirit in our minds that would affect our tongues as to what we do and what we say. We got to get rid of all bitterness. We got to get rid of rage and anger and brawling and slanderous spirits. We must empty ourselves. When I look at the 29th verse of Ephesians, the 29th verse here of the fourth chapter, he said, let no corruption proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying. We got to understand that there's power in our tongues, but depends on what comes out of our tongues can be a damnation to what God has in store for us. But we have to empty ourselves to be able to get the goodness of what God has for us. When I look at the 30th verse, he says, grieve not the Holy Spirit of God. Now, we already know that the Holy Spirit is a part of the Godhead. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Which means that when the disciples was wondering about who will be with them when Jesus told him he had to leave, he said, I'm going to leave you a holy comforter. And that holy comforter is the Holy Spirit. God is good. God is worthy to be praised. I know that God can do anything but fail. I need you to just go back a few moments, because there's been some points that was left behind. And I just want to go over this again. Acts 2 and 4. It says, and they wired all filled. They were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And the theme, again, I want to share with you, the theme this morning is the flow of God's power. The flow of God's power. We look at this text. There was a day of Pentecost. Some may ask the question, well, what is Pentecost? In the New Testament, the day that the Holy Spirit descended upon the disciples. Matter of fact, Pentecost commemorates the descending of the Holy Spirit on the apostles and the disciples, following the crucifixion, the resurrection, and the ascension of Jesus the Christ. After being with Jesus for his years of ministry, being with him for his 40 days after his resurrection, and witnessing his return to heaven, believers needed this event to help them, to help us be what Jesus wanted them to become. There was a researcher that came out with 7 points of conditions that hang very heavy with many believers. And one of those was that, and this research was done by the Bonner Group. And one of the things they talked about is that as Christians, many of us, we look at faith as being very important in our lives. We looked at the fact that personal responsibility to share our beliefs with others, not just among ourselves. And that we had a firm understanding that Satan does exist, maintaining the eternal salvation is possible only through grace, not by being good or doing good deeds. We had an understanding that asserting that Jesus lived a sinless life here on this earth. We also had a clear understanding that the Bible is totally accurate in all teachings. And then number 7, describing God as the all-knowing, all-powerful, perfect deity who created the universe and still rules today. That was back in 2004 when this research was done among Christian groups. But we're finding today that some of us are getting away from even talking about Satan really existing. Some are getting away from the fact that the Bible is totally accurate in all teachings. They're even beginning to revise and come up with different writings of what the Bible is saying that is not the Word of God. We got to also continue to maintain and understand that eternal salvation is possible only through grace and not by our works and deeds. We're getting a little soft in that area, But the reality is that we must understand, in order to flow in God's power, we got to understand that Satan does exist. In order to flow in God's power, we got to understand that the Bible is totally accurate. Totally accurate in all its teachings. If we're going to flow in God's power, we must understand that God is all-knowing. God is all-powerful. The perfect deity who created the universe and still rules right now, this day. He's the same God yesterday, the same God today, and the same God forevermore. In this first verse of the second chapter, the Holy Spirit came 50 days after his resurrection and 10 days after his ascension. Tongues symbolize speech and the communication of the gospel. Let me say it again. Tongues symbolize the speech and the communication of the gospel. When you talk about cloven tongues, which means the fire separated and rests in each of us, fire symbolizes God's purifying presence, which burns away the undesirable elements of our lives and set our hearts aflame. In order to get this fire, there are some things that are necessary. I'm talking about the flow of God, the flow of God's power. One of those things is that we need to become empty that we might be filled. These early disciples had to get rid of some things in their lives that kept them from what God had intended for them in their lives. When we talk about the flow of God's power, and we talk about becoming empty, I look over in Ephesians, the fourth chapter. Ephesians, the fourth chapter, 21:31, Paul says, if you heard him, talking about Christ, if you heard him and been taught by him, you will put off former conversations of man. That's, let me say it again. Paul says, if you heard him and have been taught by him, you will put off former conversations of man. In other words, Paul is saying, and is telling the Ephesians to leave behind the old life. Leave behind that old life. And empty yourselves from old baggage. I can tell you right now, don't let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths. But only what is helpful for building the kingdom. In the 23rd verse of the 4th chapter of Ephesians says that Be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and truth and true holiness. The flow of God's power. We got to get rid of some stuff. We got to get rid of all bitterness. We got to get rid of anger. We got to get rid of brawling. We got to get rid of slanderous talk that affects the spirit of that which God wants us to do and to become. We must empty ourselves. For when I look at the 29th verse, he says, let no corrupted communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying. I can tell you a lot of times we speak death that comes from the tongue because we are not speaking in righteousness, but we are speaking in the darkness from the pits of hell. I can tell you, we got to empty some stuff. For the word says, grieve not the Holy Spirit of God. Don't make the Spirit of God sad. Don't let us grieve the Holy Spirit. What is the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit is God, Jesus himself. When the disciples was wondering about who would they have when Jesus told them he had to leave them, and Jesus said, look, I'm not going to leave you alone, for I'm going to leave you with the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit represents the three Godheads, God the Father, God the Son, now the God, the Holy Spirit. That's good news, church. Don't make the Spirit sad. We must empty ourselves. And we must be able to understand the flow of God's power is through the Holy Spirit. And then the second point I want to bring to you here is that we need to be empowered by the Holy Spirit. But you can't be empowered by the Holy Spirit if you don't allow the Holy Spirit to come in. The disciples ran into and hid in a room when Jesus had died on the cross. They were fearful for what has happened. And the point that I'm making here is that God will empower us, but we must have the faith. We must be able to speak and know that God is real. But when we speak disaster, disaster will then come. But I want you to understand, when we speak of the power of the Holy Spirit, it makes a difference. They needed to be empowered. The disciples needed to be empowered. When I look at Luke 24:49, Jesus said to them, behold, I sent the promise of my Father unto you, but tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you are come and has been given the power from on high. That's powerful, church. We got to spend time with God. We got to spend time with the Lord. We just don't get this by osmosis, but we get this by spending time with the Lord. In Acts 1:4-5, being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which he had heard. We got to be patient. We got to understand that God has it all in control. We need to know that to be empowered by the Holy Spirit gives us what we need to flow in God's power. Isn't God good? When I look at the fourth verse, the fourth verse, it says, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. I just want you to understand and know that when you spend time with God, He'll give you just what you need. He'll give you just the words to say what needs to be said. And those words will be power coming from God Himself. When you're trying to deal with the supervisor on your job, you got to allow the Holy Spirit to work within you. And God will give you the power to say what needs to be said. When you're dealing with the problems of social unrest, don't try to lean on your own understanding. But when you spend time with God, God will give you the right message to come from your tongue that will give power to a restless situation. When the day of Pentecost fully came upon their lives, the church then came on one accord. I just want to say to you churches, we need to now spend some time with the Lord. We need to tarry with the Lord. Spend time with the Lord. But I just want you to understand that spending time with the Lord is not what a lot of times we hear when we talk about tarrying for the Holy Ghost. Because when I look over in the first 13, it says, though I speak with tongues of men and angels and have not love, I have become a sounding cymbal. Which means that we have to have the right fire on our tongues with love that will make a difference. This ties right into the power and the flow of God's power. I can tell you that the day of Pentecost made a difference. There would be a sound like the mighty rushing wind, where wherever we are sitting, God's Spirit will come upon us. He will cloven our tongues like fire and will be on accords going into the dying world, giving the gospel of good news. I can tell you that's good news. The flow of God's power will go forth. The flow of God's power will go forth. The flow of God's power, I say, will go forth. When flowing in God's power, you'll walk right. When flowing in God's power, you'll talk right. When flowing in God's power, you'll live right. When flowing in God's power, you'll live right. When flowing in God's power, you'll be able to reach a dying world and let them know that the wages of sin is still death, with power from the tongue, and the gift of God is still eternal life. I can tell you right now that the flow of God's power, He uses us to be able to spread the word by way of the Holy Spirit that is within us to get to a dying world. I just want you to know that we are confronted with a lot of challenges, but I just want you to know that God is able. God is able to do anything but fail. I can tell you right now that if we are talking about flowing in God's power. We got to get out of our power. We got to get out of our green power. We got to get out of our black power. We got to get out of our white power. But we got to get into God's power. Because God's power will give us all power to do His will His way. Know that God is real and that God is able to keep us from stumbling. God is able to keep us from falling. God is able to hold us. God is able to keep us. God is able to continue to lead us. I'm talking about the flow of God's power. He will keep us. He will give us everything that we need. But we got to trust Him. I know that God is able. Do you know He's able? I just want you to know that the doors of the church are now open. And when I talk about the doors of the church are now open, I'm not talking about four walls and a building. But I'm talking about, because we are the church. And those of us who are saved, sanctified, and baptized believers, we are the church. And we are saying to a dying world, the doors are open. Come on and go with me to my Father's house. There's joy. Joy. There's unspeakable joy in my Father's house. He's already made the promise He'll never leave us, nor will He forsake us. Somebody may not have a church home right now. Why don't you just come on and be a part of the house of God? Be a part of that olive branch, to know that God is able to do anything but fail. You may be sick right now, physically, but know that God is still a healer. You may be worried about your finances. Understand right now, if you trust God, the flow of God's power will not give you what you want, but He'll give you what you need. You got to be able to trust Him and know that He's able. He's able to keep you from stumbling. He's able to keep you from falling. There might be someone that wants prayer right now, somebody that wants a church home right now. These doors are open. You can just go to our website and just leave the information there. There's somebody that might be online right now. Let me know that you hear the word today. Let me know that the word has gone forth today. Let me know that God is still real. Can we trust Him? Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we come this day as humble as we know how, just to say thank you. God, we're still seeking the flow of your power, knowing that your power is in your word, that your power is in prayer and fasting. We know, God, that you are able to do anything, that you're the same God yesterday, the same God today, and the same God forevermore. Bless right now, God. Bless our sick and our shut in, wherever they may be. Continue to bless Sister Greenwell. Bless Brother Philip Jones. Bless Brother Jordan in the name of Jesus. God bless right now Todd and Mia. For you know what each one of these individuals are standing in the need of. God, you are still able to do what you say that you always said you would do. I thank you right now for your power. I thank you right now for your Holy Ghost power. And oh God, when we speak, let our tongues be on fire in order to edify your name, edify your kingdom, edify the love that you have showered upon this universe. Edify the love that you have shared with every one of us in the name of Jesus. Bless right now, God. For we know that you're able. We know that you're able. And oh God, right now, bless this communion. For 30 days have gone by. And we are now here to commemorate the death, the burial, and the resurrection of you, Lord. We know that we are not serving a dead God. We know that we are not serving a dead God, but we are serving a living God. We ask you, oh God, to bless every individual that is about to partake in this communion service. For we recognize that 30 days have gone by, whatever mess that we have been caught up in. Oh God, you have given us the opportunity to let it go. We ask you, oh God, that we don't want this communion to be a damnation to our souls because we refuse to let go the mess. But oh God, we are letting go the mess right now in order to be blessed. Bless us right now. Guide us and keep us. In all these blessings we ask in your name we pray. Amen and amen. Today, this bread represents the given body of our Lord Savior Jesus the Christ. This wine represents his shed blood. And it's the blood that's going to keep us. It's the blood that's going to hold us. It's the blood that's going to heal us. And as we take, eat, and drink, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, after the disciples had eaten, they went out into the Mount of Olives. There are no Mount of Olives today, but there's still the highways and the byways of this life that we who are baptized believers of Christ, we ought to go to the highways and the byways, letting men and women, boys and girls, know that the wages of sin is still death, and the gift of God is eternal life. Amen. And amen. I just want to say today that I thank you again for joining us in this broadcast, and that you please feel free to email us, go on our website, call us to gain more information about us. We just love the Lord, and we want to do that which will be pleasing unto the Lord. We thank you this day. I want you to be able to, when you leave this broadcast, walk by faith, not by sight. Seek the element of the Holy Spirit to come into your life. Who is the Holy Spirit? It's Jesus himself. Because he'll walk with you. He'll talk with you. He'll never leave you alone. God bless you all. And I want you to have a great morning in Jesus' name. God bless you.